this morning, the 8th of August 2020. I felt the urge to share some advice about wearing a mask, not the anonymous mask of Q or other anons sprouting like weeds and sunflowers all over the virtual place. No wearing a mouth mask, damp with an M&S solution. To be very practical, and I leave this whole text below the video for you to read. To be very practical, since wearing face masks or mouth masks are mandatory in many parts of our planet, in public places and public transport, I suggest to make the mask not only a cover that you're obliged to wear, but also provide a disinfectant with it, protecting you from spreading and inhaling bed bugs. MMS is a remedy introduced by Jim Humble some decades ago. Initially, he used it as a water purifier since he traveled in the jungle of Africa. His comrades suffered from malaria fevers, and one day he chose to use MMS on his comrades, see how it would affect their symptoms. To his surprise, one of his comrades' fever stopped within hours, and all of them recovered in a short period of time. That's how Jim began to treat malaria patients in Africa and cures thousands of them. The Red Cross has used MMS as well, but Big Pharma has made great efforts to ridicule Jim's remedy and published reports about it, saying that it was equal to bleach. Now that we are decades later since that time, many cases treated with MMS are the proof in the pudding. Jim Humble has published his COVID-19 advice using an MMS protocol since the pandemic was announced in early spring, March 11, 2020. Here is an excellent explanation of what chlorine dioxide, aka MMS, is by Kerry Rivera. You will find the links below in the text. The idea is, and it's my experiment, to add a mixture of MMS on the inside of the mouth mask, and by wearing it, inhale the damp of MMS that is on your mouth mask, keeping your lungs clean as well, bringing the inside of your body in touch with the disinfectant in the bloodstream so that it kills pathogens in your body. Pathogens. Pathogens are the residue, the result of an infection. You could call them toxins, and MMS a detoxification remedy. I've tried it out in the last days since I found that a tick has visited me, probably. I'm not sure, I haven't seen the creature, but the bite looked like as if there has been such a visitor. It doesn't show exactly as it should show, according to the medical experts. So I'm not worried at all. I'm doing this experiment as prevention of possible effects by that tick bite. Not all ticks cause trouble, of course. I'm not worried at all, keeping my immune system strong. Skin rashes and insect or snake bites can be treated with MMS as well. All forms of poisonous effects and infection effect. Also food poisoning. Now, I should make clear that I'm trying this out entirely as a new experience, and I can't tell you if it works yet. This is my own choice and responsibility, and you need to take yours. See what I mean? Just try it out when you feel it's valuable for you. And above all, read Jim Humble's detailed explanations and advice. It's thorough. Don't hurry and don't think that you can mix the remedy and drink it at random. It's a strong potion and it doesn't taste nice. Just inform yourself properly about what MMS is and its effect. When you don't happen to have MMS in the home, you can order MMS here. See the link below in the text. A German provider who serves almost entire Europe and, of course, the rest of the world. This provider sells MMS as water purifier, and you'll find it under that name on the website. I'm Dutch and also, and so I know only of European providers. The UK has none. The solution I've made is as follows. Keep your clean mouth mask ready, self-made or prefabricated, doesn't matter. Place it on a plate with the inside visible. By the way, a ceramic plate, not a metal plate. Fold the mouth mask open and place it on the plate with the inside visible. Pour 4 drops of bottle number 1 and 4 drops of bottle number 2 in a medium-sized glass. Stir it by moving the glass a bit so that the two are mixed. You can use a wooden spoon or chopsticks from the Chinese, or a spoon made of bone, no metal. The color of the mixture in the glass is light amber, opaque. Add water or clean rainwater to the mixture and fill the glass halfway. Stir by moving the glass a bit or use the spoon and pour a few drops on the inside of your mouth mask until it's damp wet, not dripping wet. Excess fluid is no problem. You can pour it in the glass or wet a second and third mouth mask with it. Whatever is working for you is best. When there's an emergency, wear the mouth mask immediately and breathe normally through it. Don't change your breathing pattern at risk of starting to hyperventilate and faint. When you choose to wear your mouth mask all of the time, when going out, put it on also. Otherwise, take the mouth mask or more than one, prepared with MMS, with you in a plastic bag and wear it when you must wear it. Just observe and be vigilant when an effect occurs that makes you feel uncomfortable. The solution that you've made can be put in a small spray bottle or stored in a small bottle of dark glass, preferably, and put in the plastic bag with the mouth masks so that you can refresh the substance during the day when you wear your mouth mask. When you take it off, place it in the plastic bag again so that it remains moist. You can wear it again, for the disinfectant on it keeps it clean. Please choose your own manner of using new mouth masks frequently, or spray or wet your present mouth mask that you are already using. Put a new moist mouth mask each time you need to wear one. You can prepare a couple of them at home before going out to work or elsewhere. When you've got questions or feedback about this comment of mine, please let me know by leaving a comment. Jim Humble and Carrie Rivera are experts that are practicing with MMS for many years, and they answer questions too. Carrie Rivera is a homeopath. Also, she offers seize therapy, removing toxins left by vaccines in children who suffer from autism and ailments related to autism. I believe that when you keep your immune system strong, that there's not much risk of contamination. With a healthy immune system, a nasty bug may enter your body, but it will be neutralized and released through your digestive system, where lots of bacteria flourish to keep your digestion healthy and your energy tip-top. Apart from MMS, there are other purifiers and disinfectants, such as sodium bicarbonate. So far, I've used it externally, although whitening your teeth can be done with this one. Read instructions and inform yourself properly before using it. When in doubt, don't cross the street. Cleaning vinegar is a good disinfectant for tabletops and kitchens, at home or in public places like restaurants and pubs. It can be used to clean the windows in your home as well. You can take it with you and use it to disinfect objects. When you don't use chemicals in the home or in the bathroom or shower, your sense of smell and touch is sensitive to those alien substances that can be truly called aggressive, in my opinion. Natural remedies will do the job for me. I'm not afraid of dirt or soil making my hands dirty. Once in my very young life, my mother crashed a bottle of ammonia in the cellar, and when I needed to ask her something, opening the cellar door, I was struck by the ammonia fog rising up into my nose and brain. That was an enlightening experience for sure, as long as it lasted. For a moment, I was in another realm. around the ammonia dimension. Living with bugs and other crawly critters seems to become the new normal with one aggressive bug forced upon us. Present among us, impossible to ignore due to mass mind programming that is looked upon by many as reliable mainstream media. I don't mean any disrespect. Many people are doing the best they can. And there's lots of courage. Let's enjoy Bugs Bunny's company without being ruled by fear, and foremost, let's think for ourselves and choose our lifestyle in freedom by welcoming this comment or leaving it alone for what it is to you. Be safe and good health to you.